Won't you spare me over till another
Survival depends on the choices you make. They will be as a compass guiding you through the unknown. Will you find the path to salvation or be lost in the darkness forever? Let me speak plainly. You're about to make some difficult decisions. Decisions that will affect the lives of others. How those decisions play out will become clear over time. I expect you're wondering who I am and where you are. I am the curator, the custodian of tales. My purpose is to keep a record of everything you do, every decision or mistake you make. This is my repository. It is filled with untold stories. Stories about friends and enemies, loyalty and betrayal, life and death. Understand that I am not here to help you. Although I have been known to bend the rules. From time to time. To descend into the unknown alone is extremely brave. Or extremely foolish. Perhaps there is more to you than meets the eye. Let me give you a few words of advice. Throughout the story, you will encounter certain pictures. Pictures which allude to possible outcomes. I suggest you pay attention to their meaning. It could foreshadow a future best avoided. But alas, sands of time have run out for us. We'll meet again soon to see how you fare. Or fail.
Trip. Not particularly.
Welcome to Camp Slayer. You're early.
Apologies for arriving early, Lieutenant. Things are moving fast.
I hear you, Colonel. Glad to have you on board. Techs are ready for your presentation. As soon as we get word from the CEO, we're good to go.
You should read this.
Didn't you hear? There's a new king in the castle.
Looks that way. You are?
This is my assistant, Clarice Stokes.
Dr. Clarice Stokes.
Kolchak. First Lieutenant Kolchak.
Well, the briefing room?
What's up, Marine? Can't you keep up?
This could be our last time together, Rachel. After what happened at the checkpoint, I thought I was done. These last few weeks, you've lifted me up. I don't know where I'd be without you.
Rachel King?
Colonel King has arrived on base, ma'am. He's en route to the briefing room.
I'll be there in 5. Fuck, it's him. He's early.
Your husband, you mean? Don't you think it's about time you came clean?
Put your clothes back on. Straighten up.
Hey, Rachel. Are you gonna tell him about us or what? You and Eric have been apart for a year. Whatever you had, it's gotta be over. Come on.
Baby, I just don't think this is the right time.
That's bullshit. There's never a right time.
Soon, Nick. I promise. Soon.
I'll see you at the briefing.
Shit.
You'll have to excuse the noise and disorder. We're just getting the base set up. Blows my mind. Only a few weeks ago, Saddam was living it up in here, chowing down on candy bars while some poor bastard clipped his toenails.
Nice image.
If only you could see the state of this place now. Makes me smile. We got the CIA. We got the Army, the Marines, DIA, the Air Force. Hey, everyone's invited. Everyone wants a piece of history. God bless America. I see you, old man. Keep busting out those reps.
Hey, you come join me. Maybe I'll teach you a thing or two.
Later. We have company.
Yeah. What you miss here would like to watch me get my sweat on, huh? You wanna spot me, little lady?
Can see you just fine from here, thanks.
Ignore Corporal Merwin. He lacks social skills.
I guess every unit has its resident jackass.
Sergeant K. This is Lieutenant Colonel Kane. Just taking him down to the briefing room.
Yeah, gotta go get prep.
I'll see you in there, Marine. So what's his malfunction?
Nick ain't been himself lately. We got caught up in a shooting a few weeks back. A civilian ate a bullet. Nick took it hard.
Is he combat ready?
He's a big boy, sir. He's ready. Damn, Joey, they got you sitting behind a desk? You want me to make a call?
Nah, I'm all good. People who sit behind desks don't tend to catch so many bullets, you know? So this must be the one and only satellite guy.
The one and only satellite guy. I'm Eric King. Lieutenant Colonel Eric King.
Give the Colonel full site access. Sir. I'm telling you, when the Queen bitch finds out about this, she's gonna flip her shit.
Rachel and I, we know each other. She'll understand all's fair in love and war.
Sir?
The Queen bitch you're referring to is his wife. Nice work, Hotshot.
Sir, I'm so sorry. Rachel never said she was married.
We've been working apart this last year. So, she's the queen bitch now. She's gone up in the world.
If it helps, we like to think of it as a term of endearment. Shut up.
I hope the bandwidth can cope with the data.
I'll leave the techie stuff to you.
And I'll leave the heavy lifting to you.
You got a deal, lady.
What is this place, anyway? Looks like an old ballroom.
That's exactly what it is. I guess Shaddam liked to get down on the dance floor.
I think if his dance partner stepped on his foot, it'd be an instant off with her head.
It wouldn't surprise me.
Maybe when we're done, I'll let you spin me around a little.
As long as you don't step on my foot.
Colonel King.
Mrs. King.
Eric, this is my team. And if you want to brief them, you clear it with me first.
I should have warned you I was moving the briefing forward. That's on me. But things escalated, I had to move fast.
I have a duty to my team to stay ahead of the curve.
I understand, Rachel, but CENTCOM has given their orders.
Orders?
I'm now commanding officer. I didn't mean for you to find out like this. Truly. I'm sorry, Rach.
Somehow I doubt that very much.
This is from SOC Central. It confirms that Lieutenant Colonel King has assumed control of this operation.
I'm gonna need access to your network.
I'll patch you through. Name?
Dr. Stokes. You can call me Clarice.
Dr. Stokes, please prepare the presentation.
You found something?
Fuck is that? Modern art or something?
This is footage from the highly classified Kalis program.
That's supposed to mean something to me.
It's a thermal satellite system that I personally pioneered.
Oh, well, I'm impressed. Please, pioneer away.
You behave like this in all your briefings, Corporal?
Boys are just eager to catch a break, sir. No harm meant.
Very well. Satellite sweeps of the war zone have uncovered what appears to be an underground storage facility. This will, of course, require further investigation, but I strongly suspect it's where Saddam's chemical weapons are hidden.
We got you, you son of a bitch.
CENTCOM has given the green light to raid the facility and seize any weapons on site. Hostilities may be over, but there are holdout groups of Republican Guard all over the country. They could deploy those weapons at any time, so we need to move fast. The Army is giving us a ride out there in their helos. On arrival, Lieutenant Kolchak will lead the raid on the facility. Once it's secured, we'll carry out a full weapons inspection. Now listen up. There's been a change of leadership, but Rachel's operational expertise and local knowledge is just as valuable as ever. She'll be flying with us, and I want you all to show her the same respect. Any questions?
What the fuck are we waiting for? I'm ready.
That's tribal territory out there, Colonel. Make no mistake, those people are feral. I take it we're getting their support?
Nah, too many birds could bring them down on us. We move fast in, fast out.
Yeah, that's pretty much what your mama said to me.
Hey, careful, boy. If I didn't pull out so fast, it could have been your poppy.
All right, that's enough, Merwin. Sir, what's your call?
I'll put in a request for air support to be on standby.
Our birds can fly low under the radar. The site is in the Zagros Mountains, so we'll have plenty of ground cover.
We go dark until weapons are secured. If we don't break radio silence within 24 hours, CENTCOM will mount a rescue operation.
A lot of shit can go down in 24 hours.
I'll quit being a bitch.
I'm just saying, that's all.
This is why we went to war. This is what gets us out of bed every morning. Make no mistake, ladies and gentlemen, this is how we stop Saddam from using these weapons. Be ready in 1 hour. Dismissed. Clarice, help me set up the equipment.
I'm on it.
I don't know, man. This don't feel right. I'm getting this tingle down the back of my neck.
Oh, sweetie, look. Good rug down will sort that right out, huh?
I'm serious. I've got a real bad feeling about this.
That's what you get from spending too much time with Eric.
Is there anything you can do?
I'm gonna download the latest satellite data.
You can have some alone time with him. Thank you, Clarice. Eric, we need to talk. There's something I have to tell you.
You should know, it wasn't my decision to take over your operation. Rach, this is it? Everything I've worked on these past years, it's ready. This is the big break we've been waiting for.
This isn't about us, Eric.
I just want things to go back to the way they were.
How we left it, things weren't so great between us.
We've been through worse. A lot worse.